feel the mystery. You provide us for me.
Today is a day of brand new possibilities. We're going for it today. So I need you to share. I need you to tell your neighbor, tell your friends, tell everybody that Life Builders Church is on the edge. Get to it. Get to it. Because God got us on the edge of our seat. And there's great expectation from the presence of the Lord. So let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Share. Let's be ready for worship. Be back, children. Come on, Shane. Yes, sir. Wow.
Open my eyes.
Yeah. T-Real, call the Lord. Tell him how you feel.
Maybe I succeeded a little. I jumped up from the floor to the middle. You think I want the credit? I don't. This burglary ain't made for me. No, I know who sits on the throne, who makes the stage and writes the songs. And I know I couldn't do this on my own. And as much as I complain, I've seen more sunshine than rain. And I can wait for lucky stars, but that's not where my blessings are. No, they come from the Father's heart, not the sky, not the chance. But truth is, I'm not lucky. So I fall to my knees and I say that I pray for you. Every morning starts with someone who thanks my lucky stars, 'cause that's not where my blessings are. No, they come from the Father's heart, not the sky, not the chance. But truth is, I'm not lucky in love. Yeah, I'm not lucky in
love. Oh my God, y'all hear this word? I'm not lucky, I'm loved. Y'all hear me? I'm not lucky, I'm loved. My God, loved by God, loved by His favor, loved by His faithfulness. He is so awesome, He is so powerful, He is so mighty. My God, beloved, we get ready to go into worship. Oh, in God good, in God faithful. Father, we give you praise and we thank you that this is the day that you have made. We rejoice. And we're glad in it. We're grateful for it. So, Father, have your way today. No flesh glories in your sight. But we bow our hearts. We bow our lives. We bow the knee and we exalt you. Have your way today. Pour your spirit out today. Lord, move by your power today. And God, you arise and every enemy be scattered. Have your way. Make known your power. Make known your presence and be glorified. And we will not touch your glory, nor we hear your praise. But we give it all to you now. In Jesus' name, amen. Hallelujah. Welcome to Life Builders Church. Welcome, my God, to this time of worship, this time of adoring God. Adoration is in order. Praise is in order. Worship is in order. So let's get ready to give it to him now. Pastor Al's preparing to come to lead us into worship. Now, what I need participants, not observers. God hears your worship. While we lead, we are leading into worship. So we don't want you sitting watching us. We want you to enjoy God with us. Isn't that right, baby?
Right.
Looking so fine. Hallelujah. Thank God for his amazing love, his kindness. Looking good today. Hallelujah. Thank you, God, for his favor.
Amen.
My God. Let's go. Let's worship together.
Hallelujah. It's time Hallelujah. To worship the Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, God, we give you praise. We give you glory. We give you honor. We give you adoration. Oh, God, we bless your name right now. For you alone are holy. You alone are mighty. You alone are wonderful. You alone are omnipotent. We bless you, God, right now. We give you the honor, the glory, and the praise. What an awesome God you are. What a glorious God you are. Lord, you're mighty.
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 We
worship you, Lord.
Lord,
we give you glory,
Lord, you're mine.
Give you praise,
Lord, you're mine.
We bless you. your glory above the heavens and the earth, yes. When I think of all you made, the sun, the moon, and the stars, no praise is high enough to express how great you are. What a mighty God, what a mighty God we serve. Oh yes, give all of the glory, yeah. A mighty God we serve. Angels, they bow before the mighty God we serve. Blessing of the Lord, the favor of the Lord. We'll be right back. Hallelujah.
Beloved, I believe that God is mighty and worthy of praise, worthy of honor, and worthy of glory. I want you to share. My God, as we prepare to hear the word, we're going to cut the trough for the word by the worship. We're going to go forward in the mighty name of Jesus, and we're going to honor God for his great grace, his tender mercy, and his love. He is truly wonderful. He is truly awesome. And beloved, there's a song, my God, that we want to share in this time, my God, and we want you to be blessed by the word of the living God. We want you to know that God is with you. God is for you. God is greater than anybody could ever imagine. There is no shadow of turning with him. There is no false witness that can stand before him to declare he's a failure. to declare he's not good, to declare he's not mighty, to declare he's not awesome, to declare he's not powerful. As Pastor Al is coming back now, my God beloved, we're preparing our hearts, we're preparing our minds to hear a word from God. I need you right now, if you haven't, share that the broadcast of Life Builders Church is on the air. We're here to worship. Baby, come and bless the people. Let's get our hearts and minds ready for the word. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Bless the name of the Lord. Glory to God. God wants to bless his people today. He wants to bless us. He wants to shine his favor upon us. He wants to anoint us, bless our seed, from generation to generation. We bless your name. Hallelujah, we worship you. We give you glory, we give you honor, we give you praise. We worship your name. Hallelujah. The Lord bless you and keep you. Make his face to shine upon. Be gracious to you. Lord, turn his face towards you and give peace. And give peace. We bless your name. Hallelujah. The Lord bless you and keep you. Make his face shine upon and be gracious to you. Lord, turn his face towards you and give peace. And give peace. See?
Receiving God's best. Thank God for that word. Thank God for his faithfulness to declare his word. Don't you know and feel the presence of the Lord? How exciting it is to feel his presence, to know he's in the place, and to know he is so faithful. My God, let's hold up our Bibles and let's declare. Thank you so much, baby. Let's hold our Bibles and declare. Lord, I thank you that I have my Bible. It is a personal copy. It is my personal copy of basic instruction before leaving earth. I am a believer, not a doubter. I'm not just a hearer, but also a doer. And my life is so much better because I hear the word of the living God. Therefore, I declare my mind is alert. My heart is receptive. I will not be distracted, but I will hear what thus saith the Lord. And as a result of what I hear today, somebody declare I'm going to leave this experience better than I came here in Jesus' name. Beloved, I want to talk from the topic today, filled for fulfillment. Filled for fulfillment. Now I want us to all gravitate to this truth. Hear me. If you really want something, if you really have to have something, if you really want to do something, you will allow nothing to stop you. If you really want something, if you really want to do something, you will allow nothing to stop you. This pandemic has done several things, but I want to grab this. It's revealed a lot about the want to. This pandemic has revealed a lot about the want to. I mean, you can look at this perspective how you choose, but I don't want you to be offended, but it's the truth. Folk wanted to go to church so bad that they ignored the health protocols. They wanted to have that revival so bad that they ignored the safety protocols and didn't wear masks. There are people that want to go to bars so bad, want to go to clubs so bad, want to march in protest so bad that they don't wear masks. They haven't observed social distancing. They've started declaring untruths about masks being bondage. started talking about how they feel in prison. Now, I'm not talking politics. I'm talking want to. Because folk have been seen to do what they really want to do. I mean, in the midst of the pandemic, folk that wanted to go on vacation, if a spot was open, they found it and went. Even if it meant driving from the East Coast to the West Coast. I'm not condemning, I'm just stating a fact. The want to has really shown us its head in this pandemic. Why are you saying that, Bishop? Because, beloved, we have believers who want more of God and will not be stopped despite not being able to go into a building. They'll pray, they'll read the word, they'll go online, and while none of that is the same as really being in the house of God, your want to drives you to his presence. I mean, for a time, we couldn't go to the gym. Now, I've never been a gym person. I've always done my own thing. If I have exercise equipment, if I have the ability to do push-ups, if I can ride my stationary or mobile bike, I'll do that, which I do. Got my bag hanging in the basement, I'll punch it because I want to be in shape. I want to work on my cardiovascular. I want to continue to drop the excess weight. Some will say I can't go to the gym, so I can't exercise. Do you want to? Push-ups are still in stock. Can I get a witness? Leg lifts, sit-ups are still in stock. Planks, oh my goodness, are still in stock. The Bible is not closed unless you keep it closed. Your prayer time is not off limits unless you make it off limits. Your worship ability is not something that's forbidden unless you see it as such. What I'm trying to get to is God wants to fulfill your life. And he's not allowing a pandemic. He's not allowing coronavirus. He's not allowing COVID-19. He's not allowing some buildings open at 10%, some open at 25%, some open at now 75%. God is still God, and he still has a plan for your life. I'm asking this question more than once in the message. How bad do you want it? He wants it for you. Do you want it for yourself? Oh, God. God wants to. And he has shown us in his word that he desires above all that we prosper and be in health, even as our soul prospers. The Bible says that God takes pleasure in the prosperity of his servant. Taking my time for a reason. The Bible says he will show me his way, lead me in the way he wants me to go, direct my steps, and order my steps according to his word. Blessed be the Lord God that teaches me to profit and leads me by the way I should go. He wants us to have fulfillment in life. Don't turn me off, because I'm going to show you and prove it to you. First of all, God wants us to succeed in life, and he proves it daily. Look at this text with me in Ephesians chapter 2, verse 1 through 5. Ephesians 2, 1 through 5 records the words, "And you hath he quickened, who were dead in sin and trespasses, wherein time past you walked according to the course of this world, according to the prince of the power of the air, the spirit that now worketh in the children of disobedience, among whom also we all had our conversation or manner of life in times past, in the lust of our flesh, fulfilling the desires of the flesh and of the mind, and were by nature, come on, hear this, the children of wrath, even as others were. But God, who is rich in mercy, for his great love wherewith he loved us, even when we were dead in sin, hear this, hath quickened us, made us alive together with Christ. By grace ye are saved. Oh my God, God wants you to have fulfillment. He proves it. How? Because Jesus, not only while we were dead in sins and trespasses, made us alive, but Jesus is and remains the open door, and he came to give us abundant life. Look with me at a very familiar scripture, John 10, 9 and 10. I'm proving he wants fulfillment for you. John 10, 9 and 10 declares, I am the door. By me, if any man enter in, he shall be saved, and shall go in and out and find pasture. The thief cometh not, but for to steal, to kill, and to destroy. Jesus said something. He said in verse 10, I am come that they might have life, and that they might have it more abundantly. Sound like he wants fulfillment to me, for you. He said, I have come that you might have life, and that you might have it more abundantly. Then we find that not only while we were dead in sin and trespasses, that he make us alive. Not only he came to give us abundant life, but check this out. Jesus, my God, let me calm down, promised that the Father would send the Comforter in order to lead and to guide us into all truth. Isn't that good news? Look at what the word says. John 14, 25 through 27. These things have I spoken unto you, being present with you. But the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, whom the Father will send in my name, he will teach you all things and bring all things to your remembrance, whatsoever I have said unto you. Jesus said, peace I leave with you. My peace I give unto you. Not as the world giveth, give I unto you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid. The truth is, from the word, that we are desired by God much more to realize fulfillment in life. He wants you to accomplish what he put you here for. He wants you to be what he called you to be. How bad do you want it? But it's a pandemic. But I'm tired of watching church online. Do you have the same level of fulfillment for yourself that God wants for you? Oh my God, come on. The truth is, we are filled in order to realize fulfillment. We are quickened, made alive. We are given access to abundant life. Come on, church. We are led and guided into all truth by the Holy Ghost. All this comes to show us that God wants better for us. My question is, do you want it for yourself? I mean, I know it's pandemic, but I've seen some folk act like they forgot that they're a believer. Act like they forgot that God is still God. I've seen some folk who evidence in their lives, they're not reading the word during this pandemic. They're not praying. Oh, don't turn me off. I'm not trying to condemn you. But it's evident in some of our lives that God, if I don't have routine like going to a building, then I don't have relationship with you. If I don't have routine like getting up on a Saturday, observing Sabbath, or rising on a Sunday to gather together with other believers, then I don't have relationship with you. That's foolishness. Relationship is not based on whether you get in a building or not. It's not based on whether you gather with 10, 20, 30, 50, 5,000. Without your personal desire for what God has for you, you can sit in a crowded building and not feel Him. You can stand amongst other worshipers whose hands are lifted up and it means nothing to you. What this message is about is to ask that you check your heart, check your life, and ask, do I want fulfillment like God wants it for me? My God, beloved, I'm desiring that you understand that there are some in life who do receive a measure of fulfillment. But notice the words I use. Measure. Measure. There are some young men that are about to see the end of their labor, from Pop Warner football through high school football to college football. And some have been drafted in the NFL and in a few weeks or a few days about to step on an NFL football field. Maybe it's an empty stadium, but they're about to step on the field of an NFL stadium to play a real game as a professional. They have seen a measure of fulfillment. But I understand that life, if you walk a certain way, gives you a measure of fulfillment. If you work hard, you get a measure of fulfillment. If you stick to it, you get a measure of fulfillment. But can I ask you to join me in not wanting simply a measure? My God, the Bible says that God has given us the Holy Spirit without measure. Why limit what you can do? Why limit who you can be when the power to make you be it has been given to you without measure? Oh my God, I'm trying to calm down. So many of us have put a limit on how much God has of us, have put a limit on how much we give God. But I want you to hear me. He's giving you His Spirit without measure. I don't know all I'm going to be, but I'm determined to be it. I don't know at 57 years old everything I will accomplish in life, but I'm determined to accomplish it. And I'm determined, like the Apostle Paul declared, neither life nor death, nor principalities, nor powers, nor angels, nor demons, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate me from the love of God. Beloved, can I introduce you to a hunger for more? You have the Holy Ghost without limit. You have the Spirit without limit. Yes, you may accomplish some things in life, but there is so much more you will be able to accomplish with the Holy Ghost, by the Holy Ghost, giving Him preeminent reign in your life. Oh my God, my God, one being filled without measure tells me there is no limit to what God can do through me. There is no limit to what God can do in me. There is no limit to how God can fulfill my life through the power of the Holy Ghost. My God, the Holy Ghost, Jesus, reveals our potential. Y'all heard me say it before, and I'll say it again. In John 1, somewhere around verse 11 through 13, the Bible says, He came unto His own, and His own received Him not. But to as many as received Him, but to as many as believed Him, gave He power. In that context, the word power is the word, my God, exousia, which broken down, my goodness, to its finest settle point. It means potential. God gave us by the Holy Ghost unlimited potential. But then, in Acts chapter 1, verse 8, the Bible said, Jesus said, you shall receive power. In that context, the word power is dunamis, which is the word that we get dynamite, explosive ability. So the Holy Ghost comes so you can explore your potential to one day become explosive. Y'all see what I just did? Explore your potential and now one day become explosive. God says, I have not limited you. Why are you limiting yourself? Why are you saying, I don't need all that? Why are you letting people tell you, you don't need all that? Why are you returning to habits pre-COVID? Why do you want normal? Why do you want business as usual? Why not say, Father, I'm still alive. I still have breath. I still have power. I still have potential. And now it's time to me explode. God will blow you up if you let him. And I don't mean to set you apart in pieces. I mean to expand you, increase you, empower you. But it's by the Holy Ghost. Bishop, I don't know. I mean, all this talk about what God has given us, how Jesus sent the Holy Spirit. What good is all of it? Well, the best place I can go before I finish is back to the beginning to answer this question. There was a plan that God had for Adam to pass down through to mankind. Although the omniscient God knew that Adam would mess up, he still had in his plan that we come to realize fulfillment. In Adam, all died. But in Christ, all are made alive. How is that possible? Well, Genesis chapter 1, verse 26 to 28 reminds us of what fulfillment's all about. The Bible said in Genesis 1, 26 to 28, and God said, let us make man in our image, after our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, over the fowl of the air, and over the cattle, and over all the earth, and over every creeping thing that creepeth upon the earth. Oh, there are three gods. He said, let us make man. No, there's only one God, manifesting his Father in creation, Son in redemption, Holy Spirit operating to bring to pass the plan of God in the earth. God made us to look like him, to represent him, but get the third part, to act like him in the earth, to look like him, to represent him, and to operate like him in the earth. That's why God gave us dominion over the fish, the birds, the creeping thing. He gave us dominion. Let's continue to read. So God created man in his own image. In the image of God created he him, male man and female man. He created them and God blessed them. Male and female. And God blessed them and said unto them, be fruitful and multiply and replenish the earth. Fill it with my glory. Fill it with fulfillment. Fill it with accomplished purpose. Fill it with how you act and behave in representation of me. Fill it with joy. Fill it with power. Fill it with the knowledge of the glory of God. Fill it, multiply, replenish the earth, and subdue it. Have mastery over it. Take dominion. Have dominion over the fish of the sea, over the fowl of the air, and over every living thing that moveth upon the earth. He never revoked that. Prior to the fall of mankind, God made us again in his image and in his likeness to look like him in the earth, to represent him in the earth, and to act like he would act in the earth. That's why the animals come subject, because God gave us dominion. That's why a little man can train a big whale to jump up in the air, because we have dominion. God gave us a mandate to fulfill that dominion. And again, he never revoked it. We abdicated it, we left it, but he never revoked it. So we get it back in its fullness by the power of the Holy Ghost. Yes, we have a measure to be able to function, because God created us and he put greatness in all of us. But without the Holy Ghost, measure will be all you realize. Without the Holy Ghost, that much will be all you come to know. How much greatness is in you? How much power is in you? You'll never know it unless you receive the unmeasured power of the Holy Ghost. Come on, somebody. Adam was created without limit. Can I get a witness? My God, he walked with God in the coolness of the day. Adam was able to till the garden without the use of a tractor, without the use of a plow or a backhoe. He took care of what God gave him. He had the spirit without limit. Adam's ability was without limit. He had the power to name the animals. The Bible said that God brought every animal before Adam, and whatever he called it, that's what it was. My God, beloved, whatever he spoke, it brought existence to bear. God did not give Adam ability to create another world, because that was already done. But God gave Adam the ability to speak into existence. Call those things that be not as though they were. Man, I'm preaching up in here today. My God, so many of us have limited God because we've allowed stuff to make us lazy, stuff to make us lose focus, stuff to take us away from God's original agenda. But I'm here to tell you right now that although Adam was created without measure and given full dominion, and God never revoked it, when Adam sinned, sin became the limiter. My God, when Adam sinned, my God, sin limited his lifespan. My God, sin caused there to be, my God, a limit, my God, to what we could do. God put Adam out of the Garden of Eden and said, unless you take and eat of the tree of life and live forever in that limited condition. God said in the book of Genesis that I have made the years of man to only be 120. My God, how, Bishop, you're wrong, because the Bible said God gave us 70 and it's by reason of strength 80. No, look at your word again. Somewhere, my God, around the book of Genesis, either chapter 6 or in chapter 12, it is specific that God said, man will not live like Methuselah. Man will not live 900 years. Man will not live even 300 years like Enoch, but man will live 120 years. My God, the first part of our 120 years, I would like to call the first third of your learning years. Oh my God, the second third of your giving years. Because of what you learned, now you're supposed to give, my God, back to people based on what you've learned. But the third is our reaping years. Oh, beloved, God gave us My God, 120 years. God gave us 60, not 60 and 10. My God, and with every breath we have, we are to live in fulfillment. With every area of our existence, we ought to let the Holy Ghost come in and show us how to live. I'm telling you, you can live based on measure. I'm only human. I prefer to think this way. I am spirit. I possess a soul, and I live in a body. Spirit has no limit. God put his spirit on the inside of me to make me unlimited. God have mercy. Sin limits. Laziness limits. Wrong focus limits. Wrong associations bring limit. But by the Holy Ghost, we are made alive. But by the Holy Ghost, we have access to abundant life. But by the Holy Ghost, we have potential and power to fulfill it. Lord, have mercy. I gotta get ready to close. But God has a purpose for you to fulfill. Can I get a witness? God has a work for you to do. Come on, somebody. God has an impact for you to make in the earth. My God, we can waste time in sin and trespasses. We can waste time living beneath our privilege if we want. It's your choice. But I decided I'm not going to live a limited life. Since he gave me his spirit without limit, since he gave me his power without measure, I'm going to spend my days exuding what he put in me, exhausting what he gave me, living, my God, to hear him say, "Well done, thy good and faithful servant." Who am I preaching to right now? It's by the Holy Ghost that God gives us the ability to break past limits. Oh, yes. It's by the Holy Ghost that God gives us the authority to walk in this earth and speak those things that be not as though they were. I feel like preaching up in here. But I'm trying to cause you to back off your limits, back off your measure, back off all the false impression that you've been given that you can't, you won't, they won't allow you to. Let the Holy Ghost bust down your limits. Let the Holy Ghost break up your limitation. Let the Holy Ghost, my God, give you power without measure. Oh, my God, I got to close. But you can waste time in sin and trespasses. You can waste time in low-level living. You can waste time living beneath the privilege and potential that God had for you. But I'm preaching to somebody that even in the midst of this pandemic, you got the power to rise up and live without measure. Why not live according to it? Stop trying to prove yourself as being like everybody else. Some of you all are so out of place, trying to be in sin, trying to say things you shouldn't be saying. You are living beneath your privilege, trying to be to people what you know God did not make you be. You're living low-level living, trying to be cool with folk that wouldn't give a rat about you because you're living beneath your level of potential. But God, according to 1 Peter chapter 2, verse 9 and 10, says this about us. But we are a chosen generation, a royal priesthood, a holy nation, a peculiar people, that you should show forth the praises of him who have called you out of darkness into the marvelous light, which in time past were not a people, but are now the people of God, which had not obtained mercy, but now have obtained mercy. God wants you to succeed in life. Oh yes, he does. God wants you to be more than you've limited yourself to be. My God, God wants you to experience unlimited living, because you have his spirit without living. My God, but my question is today, do you want it bad enough? See, some of y'all want to be cool with people and they not thinking about you. Some of y'all want to be accepted by folk who cares little about you. Some of you are afraid to walk in the fullness of God because somebody won't like you. Somebody won't want to be around you. But I'm talking to somebody who will not be led by your nose, but be led by your spirit. Will not be led by your emotions, but be led by the Spirit. Will not be led by how many friends I got on Facebook, on Instagram, on Snapchat, or in person. But I'm led by the Spirit of God, and he has given me the Spirit without measure. He filled me to experience fulfillment. He baptized me to live in fulfillment. He called me out of darkness into the marvelous light. He has given me his spirit without measure. He has called me to live the abundant life. I'm sorry if I'm offending you, but take what I'm saying and understand that he's come to give you abundant life. Can I get a witness? I'm ready to live abundantly, more abundantly, favorably, abundantly. How about you? How bad do you want it? Oh. How bad do you want it? You are wasting life on measure and limits. Gotta stop it today and receive the fullness. Father, oh God, I've done what you told me. I've declared your counsel. And I thank you that your word will not return void. Today is a day for somebody to start living life filled for fulfillment. Filled for fulfillment. Filled for fulfillment. You've wasted too much time living for everybody else. You wasted too much energy trying to please people. Because after you do the one thing they ask you, then they put another hoop up to jump through. Aren't you tired of that? Aren't you tired of living that way? Aren't you ready to live without measure? Come to Jesus today. Break the chains of limit. Receive ye the Holy Ghost. Receive ye the Holy Ghost. His spirit without measure. of Jesus. I gotta go. But I'm calling you right now to live in fulfillment, because you've been filled by the fulfiller. The Lord is your everything. Come to Jesus. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on. Come on to Jesus. Receive ye the Holy Ghost. Today is your day to stop faking the funk. Stop living beneath your privilege. Stop the Lord of living. Today is the day. Come. 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 Come today. Come today. It's time. Low level living is not for you. The way you've been living is not for you. What are you running from? You're not giving God your all. Why? You still want to hold on to things you like, which are not glorifying God. He has a better life for you, more fulfilling for you. Receive it. Receive it. Today. Father, I've done your work. Now get the glory. Beloved, if you hear me today and want to be saved, if you want somebody to pray with you, we have several ways to contact us. Somebody's waiting to receive your call. 443-776-0255. 443-776-0255. We have a website, www.lbcbaltimore.org. www.lbcbaltimore.org. You can go on there and write to us. Also, use our email, lbcministry@yahoo.com. lbcministry@yahoo.com. Three ways you can reach us. We want to pray for you. You can even write down in the comments of this social media platform. Somebody's watching, praying for you right now. Will pick up on your message and begin to do what God would have them to do on your behalf. Today is your day. You're filled for fulfillment. Love you. We are a giving church. We believe in tithe and offering. So I continue to encourage the giving, liberal of giving. Oh, God is so good. Everybody understand. My wife and I, we tithe. We're givers. We make sure our pastor, our ministries that we sow into, never will have to lack, because we are faithful to giving. God blesses us. Even when trees fall in your house, God gives fulfillment through the tree. So we praise him. We thank him, because he is the everlasting God. Well, beloved, go on that website, www.lbcbaltimore.org. There's a giving button there. Also, there's a mailing address being placed on your screen. If you want to mail it, my God, do that. Also, PayPal is our trusted resource. Use PayPal as you look up the name, Life Builders Church. Look it up by our email, lbcministry@yahoo.com. Those are the ways you get in touch for prayer. You want to join the church? We've been having people join the church while we're online. So there's no reason why you can't either. I want to be your pastor. I'm empowered to help you. Come on, be a part. Become a partner of Life Builders Church. Make it known and we'll respond and receive you. Well, we got to go. But I thank God for being filled for fulfillment. And let God arise. And every enemy be scattered. Can I roll this back a little bit? My brother, my covenant brother, Bishop William Murphy III, this song blesses me so much. I'm going to take it back just a little. Just a little. Come on. God bless you. Beloved, grace and peace be unto you, and peace be multiplied. For God dwells in the midst of Life Builders Church. God dwells in the midst of a blessed and prosperous community. Remember, you're filled for fulfillment. God bless. I love you. Oh, I love it. God bless.
It's not always the easiest thing to do, but I will wait.